Hi, my name is Miss Presley, and this is Ask a Grown Teacher. How long have you been teaching, and did you always know you wanted to teach? This will be my fourth full year teaching, and no, I didn't always know I wanted to teach. My first program that I went into in college, I wanted to be an art history major. I switched my majors multiple times before I landed on teaching, which seemed too easy, actually. And both my parents were in the education system, and I didn't want to follow in their footsteps, but you know, here I am now. Do you like teaching here more than the middle school? I love the middle school. The people at the middle school were amazing, as they are at the high school. But this is what I got my degree for. And I love this high school environment. So I enjoy teaching here at the high school more so than the middle grade. However, people at both, wonderful. Is there something or someone that motivates you? My kids motivate me. My kids, my own personal children, motivate me to do well in my job, to try to be as successful as possible. My students also motivate me to be the best teacher I can possibly be, to have patience, to have kindness and compassion. So those are the two things that motivate me. What book has made a significant impact on you? It's very, very difficult for me to pick one book. There was a novella written by Kate Chopin titled The Awakening, and that one had a significant impact on me about 15 years ago. But the impact of books usually applies to where I'm at in life or what I'm going through. So that changes and has changed. So there are multiple books that have impacted me, but that is one, The Awakening, that I can think of for an example. What's the meaning of life? Well, the meaning of life is subjective. So what my definition of the meaning of life could be, is, may not be somebody else's, but meaning of life for me is we're put here for a purpose. I believe that our purpose is to help each other. So for me, the meaning of life is to help other people or to impact other people in certain ways. Are you more of an introvert or an extrovert? Introvert, hands down. I was always very quiet in school growing up. When I was younger, I was considered extremely shy, and I was. Extremely shy, and now I'm just pretty quiet. I stick to myself a lot, not because I don't necessarily like people, but just because this is my comfort zone and I'm okay with where I'm at. How do you balance your school life and your life at home? All right, my life at home consists of taking care of my horses, taking care of my kids, my children sometimes, and essentially going to bed. I have no life outside of school. This takes up a lot of my focus. This job takes up a lot of my focus, but I love what I do when I do when I'm home. What would you say is the happiest moment or day of your life? Having my children was the happiest moment of my life. It was the most life-changing moment of my life. So I would say that would be the happiest. Do you believe in second chances? I do. I have been given multiple second chances, so therefore I would be hypocritical if I didn't give second chances myself. Now, however, I know that being an educator, this can be taken as a second chance when a student gets a zero, chances are usually given through talking about due dates or teaching. So second chances in terms of a grade that's not turned in on time, I don't believe in those. I believe in second chances in life, but not so much with the grades. What is the funniest name you have actually heard used in the real world? Lamangelo and Orangelo for a set of twins. What is your number one favorite song? My number one favorite song is Simple Man by Lynyrd Skynyrd. If you only had 20 minutes to do something before the world ends, what would you do? I would hug my children and I would pray. If someone told you that you can time travel, what year would you go to? I would go back to the year 2000 and tell myself then what not to do. Tell us about what countries you've been to. I have been to Italy, I've been to France, I've been to England, I've been to Holland, I've been to Germany, I've been to Switzerland, went through Canada. Italy was the most unique country, Switzerland was the prettiest. The city of Amsterdam was the strangest. They had open urinals on the street. That was very strange to me. And London was the most like our own cities around here. Where is one place you've always wanted to go? There's a couple. I've always wanted to go to Ireland. I've also always wanted to go to Greece. What is your favorite sport? My favorite sport to watch is football, but my favorite sport to play or to coach is basketball. You walk in your room and your dog is mac and cheese. What do you do? First, I would scream. And then second, I would eat the dog because macaroni and cheese is the most amazing food in the world. So this is Ask a Grown Teacher. My name is Miss Presley, and thank you.